At the end of our chanting, sometimes we feel, oh, today my chanting was so poor. And I'm never going to become a good chanter. Instead, you can say, Krishna, I was so distracted today, but still, you're still keeping me at your lotus feet. You're still giving me the opportunity to chant the holy names. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you for accepting this offering. I did all this is a poor offering. Please accept it, Krishna. And thank you for giving me this opportunity. So, you know, even when we are not able to focus in our bhakti, if we can have an appreciative attitude, that is what Krishna will see and Krishna will appreciate. So the taste for the holy name is not something magical. That so focus in chanting, it will come gradually, and it may be there, it may not be there. So Krishna sees not just our emotions during our chanting, he also sees feelings. He also sees our feelings about our feelings. What do I mean by this? It's not just play of words. That means, say, if we, while chanting, we feel bored. So we just feel, hey, you know, this is just every day I have to do this. And how long can I keep doing it? I just can't continue it. I just want this to be over with. There are times we may feel like that. We have a mind which is quite, Bhakti Sanskrit Thakur says, always remember that you are constantly associating with a non-devotee. And the non-devotee is your own mind. So we may feel bored while chanting. But when we are feeling bored, feeling during chanting is that we are feeling bored. But what is our feeling about our feeling? That means when we feel bored, what do we think? How can I just get this chanting over with and get on with the next things in my life? Or, Krishna, I know the holy name is supremely tasty, but somehow because of my uncontrolled mind, I'm not able to taste this holy name. Krishna, please help me. Please let me chant. So when we don't give in to the boredom, we try to refuse and reject the boredom. We try to oppose the boredom. We oppose it. Then Krishna sees that. So some devotee may have no struggle in their chanting and may sit erect, fully awake and clearly enunciating the names. And they may say the chanting is very good. Yes, it may be good, but are they actually earnestly calling out to Krishna? Some other devotee, their mind is wandering, they're feeling no taste, they're feeling bored. But during that, in their heart, they say, Krishna, I don't want to feel like this. I want taste for your holy name. Please let me, please give me some taste. Please give me some strength. Please let me chant well. Please forgive me that I am so distracted. So if we don't give in to the boredom, we oppose it. We humbly beseech Krishna. So Krishna sees our feeling about our feeling. And he appreciates that. So rather than, we can always be appreciative that, yeah, I'm not able to get taste, so I can't appreciate the holy name right now. No, I still can. I know intellectually the holy name is glorious. So I appreciate that despite my tastelessness, I still have the opportunity. So don't look at the externals, look at the internals. And even in the internals, our mind is not always controllable. But beyond the mind is our heart. Beyond the mind is our Atma, who we are. So in the mind, feelings will come and go. But as the Atma, if we maintain our intention, Krishna, I want to connect with you. That is what Krishna will see.